The Nigerian Economic Summit Group, in its role as connector, dialogue partner, watchdog, and intervener.
When you first start business, your target is to make your first million.
Seeks to change the narrative and trajectory of the Nigerian economy. Together with our partners, we're not just solving problems, but preventing them. Because when advocacy succeeds, the nation transforms for the better. But advocacy is for the strong. It takes fact-based inputs, resilience, partnerships, courage, and a lot of heroes. So be our hero. Subscribe to our channel, listen to our messages, and engage with us. Together, we can transform Nigerian lives, communities, and businesses. Welcome to the NESG Radio.
Welcome to the NESG Radio, one of the many dialogue platforms of the Nigerian Economic Summit Group. My name is Ese Igboba, your host. Here's a quick roundup of last month's high-impact corporate interventions poised to redefine agriculture in Nigeria. Let's hear from Gloria Igbo, facilitator, Nigerian Economic Summit Group, Agriculture and Food Systems Policy Commission.
Let me start by talking about our partnership as our evergreen partnership with AGRA and multiple stakeholders to drive the enactment and operationalization of the agribusiness bills that were passed into law by the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria in 2019. Two of them that were passed, there were three, but two were passed. The two that were passed is the National Agricultural Seeds Council Act and the National Fertilizer Quality Control Act. And these bills are supposed to influence business in the agribusiness ecosystem. And the second one, another thing we've worked on, we are presently working on is our collaborations with stakeholders on shaping the food system narrative in Nigeria. As you all know, that food system is something that it's on the table, and it's a burning issue, more especially the kind of things that COVID has thrown out for us. And one of the things, one of the partnerships we're working on is the FAO, European Union partnership, where they're working on, they have conducting an assessment of the national and subnational food systems in Nigeria. And this is part of the multi-dimensional assessment in low-income and lower- and middle-income countries. And we also were part of an independent food systems dialogue in January with Sahel Consulting. And we're looking at how to foster resilient, inclusive, and equitable food systems in Nigeria. And recently, we're part of a national dialogue which sought to address or to investigate private sector investments or investments, yeah. Or looking at what the private sector is doing or would do in food systems.
Now Caleb Uso, Country Manager, OCP Africa Fertilizers Nigeria Limited, shares his perspectives on sustainable fertilizer quality.
So that's why we're investing a lot with partners in Nigeria, local partners, to see how we can come up with appropriate fertilizers for different crops and different geographies of Nigeria.
Okay, great. Thank you very much. So do you, does OCP have like specialized fertilizers you particularly deal with? And how do these specialized fertilizers contribute to wheat production?
Yeah, so the process is to invest in R&D with local research institutions. And it takes a bit of time, probably 2 to 3 years, to come up with specialized fertilizer for different crops. Currently, yes, we have concluded research. Partners with IITA, IART, research institutions in Nigeria, and we have now specialty fertilizer for maize. We are also doing the same for cocoa, cassava, oil palm, sorghum, soybeans, and many other crops. So currently, we have launched a specialty fertilizer for maize. Now, how it's done with OCPs, we don't come up with those fertilizers, keep it for ourselves to solely produce. We make the outcome of this research available to the industry. So whoever is invested in fertilizer production, regardless of the brand, can adopt that and make it available to farmers.
Next, Victoria Waduka, Corporate Communications and Public Affairs Manager, Nestle Nigeria, highlights Nestle's offerings for smallholder farmers.
So one of the things that we've started to do with this inclusive grains project is to help the farmers to learn the farming practices that improves the quality of their grains. And it starts from the quality of the input. It also speaks to how they care for the crops when it's in the ground. It speaks also to the kind of fertilizer they use, the kind of chemicals that they apply, and how they use it. And so teaching them to farm better, to produce better quality crops, means that they can sell more and they can sell at a premium to companies like Nestle, who can offtake in very large volumes. And this is a guarantee to market or to assure offtaker for them on a continuous basis. Now, the second thing that we do is to also help them improve the productivity of their land. For instance, if 1 hectare is producing 1 ton, we'll work with them to ensure that it produces 2.8 and more, so that they are earning more from the effort that they put in. And this is very important because that helps to ensure that we're improving the household income of the smallholder farmers. They're able to do the basic things for their families, including feeding their families well, access to health care, access to education. So this is very important. And if we're going to grow our environment, it's important to lift everyone within our environment and ensure that they earn more and they can support themselves better. You know, we've seen a lot of rural, urban migration. We can help to reduce this if we ensure that they're able to make a decent living by doing their work on the farms.
And finally, Diana Bassi-Edem, Executive Director, Commercial Dairy and Ranchers Association of Nigeria, emphasizes that dairy concerns are best addressed at the policy level.
Thank you very much. Kudaran has been around, and Kudaran has been the collective voice of the practitioners in the dairy space. So far, we have worked on, we have collaborated with a number of government agencies, and to be specific, the Federal Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development and the Central Bank of Nigeria, the Federal Ministry of Industry and Trade and Investment. We have worked with them to come up with, we have advocated and promoted the need for us to have a national dairy policy to guide the activity of the sector. So, and I am happy to say that earlier in this year, March 2021, we were able to have a wider stakeholder engagement organized by Federal Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development in collaboration with the other agencies to review the draft national dairy policy. And this is something Kudaran has worked on over the years since inception to drive the process of sort of get the government to formulate and implement the policy to guide the activities in the industry. So this is a major impact that we have had, even though the policy is not out yet, but we have done the review and it has gone for a further review in the States. We hopefully believe that by the end of this year, we'll have another session to validate that policy before it goes for the final approval with the Federal Executive Council and the National Assembly before it becomes fully operational. So that is one thing that we have achieved.
Clearly, the potential in the agricultural sector is great. All it takes is our collective support and input to drive the sector to success. Stay tuned to the NESG Radio for updates from NESG, OCP Africa, Nestle, Codran, and more. NESG Radio is a traditionally syndicated podcast in the national interest. Visit our websites at www.nesgroup.org/podcast to listen to all our content or subscribe to our channel on YouTube, Spotify, Spreaker, Google Podcasts, and iTunes. Thank you, and bye for now.
Thank you for listening to our content today. Remember to subscribe to the NESG Radio. Follow us across all social media channels and visit our website, www.nesgroup.org/NESG Radio. NESG, in the national interest.